This is episode 10, C7. A link beyond time and space. It is a chaotic period in time. After having to watch his wife painfully die under f***ing disastrous circumstances and avoid being turned into a side table leg, an alcoholic squirrel named Conker still managed to become a crowned king. He had a somewhat unsuccessful tenure as a king. He spent all the treasury money on beer, parties, and hookers, and was eventually thrown into prison, faced with the prospect of execution. On the day his sentence was due, an event of incalculable proportions happened and freed him from his shackles. A certain time traveler called the Doctor had done the irreversible. His spaceship had exploded, and as a result, it had created a rift between many alternate realities. Pursued by a wide variety of enemies from other worlds, Conker races through the rift in a new hope to change his fate and also restore freedom to the parallel universes.
Hello everybody and welcome to a brand new Let's Play series, Conker's Hyrule Tale. Now this is a hack made by Euclid and Seth, the same guys who made Parallel Worlds. Now this was originally supposed to be a sequel to Parallel Worlds, but ended up becoming its own thing. It's an unofficial sequel to Conker's Bad Fur Day, which I'm completely fine with. Anyways, we're not going to waste any more time, so let's get started. Yeah, that's a remix of, The Great Mighty Pooh in 8-bit. And yes, this, you're probably wondering, why does the music sound so not SNES? Well, this game uses the MSU1 patch, so it comes with a whole bunch of CD-quality music. Basically, specifically handpicked for it, so the game has a whole load of custom tracks. Supposed to be an FMV sequence there, but it won't work. I don't know why, but it doesn't work. So you wake up at last, Neo. That isn't my name. I don't even know you people. You kidnapped me. Why are you doing this to me? We know who you are. What you are. I don't know what you're talking about. Seems that you've been living two lives. Yeah, this text crawl's slow. We can fix that later. One life, you're Conker and Assassin. The other life is lived in computers, where you go by the hacker name alias Neo, and are guilty of virtually every computer crime we have a law for. As you can see, we've had our eye on you for some time now, Mr. Conker. What do you want from me? For you to do as you're told. Meet my twin brother outside. He will give you more details. His twin brother is his name spelled backwards. Now you can expect that toilet if you want, but I don't recommend it. It's just some funny text. As we could talk to him, but it's just basically more Matrix spiel and then telling us this is the Animus, and it's basically Assassin's Creed joke. And it's really slow text crawl, so I don't want to go through it. My head. It hurts. Where am I? This place looks like another shitty location from a fantasy game in 8-bit, no less. How did I end up here in the first place? I don't remember Rare making a retro game like this. And nothing we can really do here right now. This sign is for changing the difficulty of the game. We're going to do it on normal, or what they consider easy. The big difference between the two difficulties is boss health and damage you take. That's it. That's really it. And the bosses become really tedious with all the health they get. It's really not worth it. Now, once you get enough stuff, honestly, it isn't a ton harder. And it's head right, left, right here, and we can move on to our first dungeon of the game. Basically the tutorial dungeon, if you ask me. Which is Ganon's lair. Alrighty, let's start by pushing this to reveal a chest, which contains a backpack. Let's look inside. There's a smartphone, a silver lighter, and a rather large bag full of red and blue pills. With the note, "Don't touch, property of Morpheus," written on its side. I can use these colored pills at any time by pressing the select button. If I want to display my smartphone menu, I need to press the start button. After opening my smartphone, I can use the L and R buttons to move between the screens. And as with our smartphone, we can see our inventory, our artifacts, Google Map Droid, and our text speed and our notebook, which will contain pathways through the Lost Woods and other places that appear. And we're going to set the text to slightly faster. And immediately head down the hole. Now, I could read a lot of the dialogue, but that means the videos would be 20 plus minutes long. And I think the main game is good enough. That tablet we passed up on will just tell us that we can skip dialogue. If you've already seen it. What's this one say, though? Ah, seems to be an instruction tablet. Oh, I see. It's for the more complex stuff. To stun enemies using your fists, just press B. I'll try that. I'll have to try that. Some enemies can be killed instantly if pushed against spikes. That seems simple enough. I turned the mic volume down by like 90% and it still feels like it's really loud. You guys let me know. I really can't make it much quieter. You can also do this, just punch him to death. It's weak, but it does the job. And anyways, we get a small key for our efforts, which will allow us to proceed into the dungeon proper. Alright, let's head left. There's nothing we can do to the right just yet. That's a little further into the dungeon. We can't do anything about that right now. I think that portal leads further into the dungeon. Much further in. Or it leads to that. But we don't need that. Can't wait for that to pass. We'll hit the thing and bounce back, and then move up. That pot that we passed on has a fairy if you need it, which I'm going to after all this. These guys give me trouble. Also, your invincibility frames are a lot less lenient in this game. It's a lot less friendlier. That's probably why they put the fairy there, because they knew you'd get boned. Alright, we're going to ignore that portal. And we're going to make our way back. And head to the right this time. Now, this dungeon isn't very long. And we should be able to complete it in the first episode here. Alright, with our key. Also, this is health. I should explain the HUD, though it's pretty self-explanatory. The little white bars are our health. The green bars are magic, which slowly refills over time. The little key symbol with the number next to it is our keys. And that... where the lighter sits is where our current inventory item is. That is the current inventory item we have equipped. Jesus. Green cash is $1. Blue is $5. Red is $20. Alrighty, let's push this owl switch statue there to keep the door open because umbrella. And if we head to the right, we can get ourselves a secret goodie in this room. Push all these blocks away, hit the button to reveal a chest, which contains a key card. It should let me gain access to all of the current location's electromagnetically locked doors and chests. Sweet. So I immediately head back to the room we opened the door in because there's a staircase in here, which will lead us to that electromagnetically locked chest. So let's use our key card to get a hookshot. What more can we say about it? It's a friggin' hookshot. Goes up from point A and B in a single button touch. Now that I have no more than one item, basically he's gonna tell us we can L and R to switch items without opening the smartphone constantly. But with slow text crawling. Thankfully I can skip stuff like that and just tell you guys what he's gonna tell us a lot quicker. While getting a move on at the very least. And so let's get our hookshot on, because it's our new toy and we want to play with it. And drop down the hole. Because in here we have... Fucktastically hard-ass optional puzzle. Not to be confused with the hard optional puzzle. Newbies, get the fuck away. So, let's complete this oh-so-hard, brain-taxing puzzle. So what do we gotta do? Well, let's start by moving this owl statue. Pushing it onto that button. That's the first step. It's the most important step, too, because that's how you complete the puzzle. I didn't think we could do it, guys. Now in here we get $20, $50, $100, and $300, and the magic harp. Well, no. Just a shitty black-white harp. Wait. Here's an inscription. Used to enlighten your path and ruins. Mysterious. Maybe it becomes handy later? It certainly does, but I've never need to use it. Alrighty, with our key card we can now open the what used to be the big key doors. I'll stun you with our hook shot and kill you. Because that's how Conker solves his problems. It's cash and violence. Now you can go back if you want, but we don't have any need to do that. So let's continue onwards. Oh there, buddy. Let's give him a good old back rubbing. Does that feel good on the spine? I hope so. Alright, now that tablet will tell you that you can do this. Yeah, you can hookshot through spikes. A rather simple technique, but still useful. Alright, let's head right, because we need to go this way first so we can proceed onwards in the dungeon. Alright, that pod and portal up there is something we won't ever be touching, but I think it contains the map of the dungeon. Because under that pod is a button. Alrighty, with that block pushed out, we can now head back and use it. Could you figure out what we were going to do from that? If not, you'll see in just a second. And that is... Hookshot across. But first I want to show something off. Notice how we don't take damage? Yes! There's no annoying fall damage in this game. So falling down a pit is not bad. It's really just an inconvenience. You'll just be sent back to the start of a room. Fairy if you need it. Restores 5 bars of health. Or 6. It's one of the two. Now we have to kill this guy. Because it'll reveal a chest. Contains a red fox tail. What a shitty tail, but better than nothing. It will make me agile enough to dodge a projectile if I see it coming. It's basically your shield of the game. Anyways, drop down the hole to confront the boss. It's Ganon. Man, this boss looks really strong. Let me get a reading on this guy's power level. What? It's over 9,000! You are my prisoner. Hey. Silence! Yeah, we have to fight Ganon. Hard mode, he's a pain in the nutsack because you take so much damage. Normal mode, not a big deal, just like the original. Just knock his fireballs back into him with your fists. The attack you want to watch out for is his lightning attack. It's unlike the original game, it won't just appear in the center, it'll appear wherever the hell it wants to. Yeah, like that. And if you're doing hard mode, you'll probably get hit twice in a row and instantly die. On normal, it does about a full heart of damage, and that's it. Like I said, the huge difference is basically damage you take and health they have, and the health they have is usually absolutely tedious. You've killed me! Good. Next time I'll kick you into the pit. No! Not into the pit! It burns! He's dead. Let's get out of here. Squadala! We're off! I imagine right now you're feeling a bit like Alice tumbling down the rabbit hole. Who are you? Careful. They are listening to us. The Matrix has you, Neo. What? What the fuck is the Matrix? Sorry, can't tell. And that's it. I think that's the last Matrix joke we're gonna get in this entire LP. Anyways, what are we gonna do next? Well, I may as well show it off really quick. Since we're gonna call it an episode afterwards, just head on through this door now. Head up the stairs to floor 2. And then once you enter this room, you'll meet the Noel guy again. Oh wait, no, he's not in here. Just step onto this pad. It'll take us out of the labs, finally. And into Peach's castle is regular Conker. Yay. So what are we going to do in Peach's castle? Well, just like Mario 64, it does act like a level select. So we're going to find out where we're going next time on Let's Play Conker's Hyrule Tale.